You will not go to the next level financially because you want money. You want money. Get so pissed at people who want me to pay them, and I got to help you do your job. I gotta pay you and I gotta help you. This is why I'm hurt, because I gotta pay you to do your job, help you with your job, and you never give me none of the money that you make. You've never come to me and say, you know what, quiet is kept between me and you. You took some of the responsibility off me. I'm gonna give you 10 grand for that. Take 10% out of my check. You're not gonna give me your money, but you're gonna give me your responsibilities. So if you can't be responsible, I don't need you. I can't hire people that only do work. I must hire people that are saying, if you wash the dishes and I gotta come behind you and see if you really wash the dishes, if I gotta look at every, I gotta give you the dishes knowing that they done. I gotta give you my car knowing that you really washed it, that you took care of it. I'll pay you whatever you want me to pay you. I just don't wanna have to come behind you, because now I got to work. And if I gotta work, I should just work in the first place. Just let me do it in the first place. Stop working for money. The real money is in responsibility. When I show up to a corporation, they know they only gotta do one thing. Tell me what you need, give me the mic, and get out my way. Whatever you told me you paying me the 75 grand for, I promise you I will deliver. You're not going to have to come up behind me and talk. You're not going to have to come up and say, based on what he said, I got to say something else. You're not going to have to come behind me to see if I'm flirting with one of your, you're not going to have to come up behind me and see if I'm talking about something else you told me to talk about. I'm responsible. Give me the check. Give me what you want me to do, and I will execute. Bottom line, are you listening to what I'm telling you? And so I need you to do me a favor. Stop the money stuff. Don't ask to get paid no more. Just go to people and say, hey, what do you need me to get off your plate? How can I help your life? What can I do? I'm human. I got stuff that I need. How can I take that off your plate? Tell you something, if there's some stuff, if you can take off my plate, I'll pay you whatever you want to get paid for, because I got more money than I got time. They print money, they don't print time. I don't care who you are, you can't go pay for another year or 2 years. I don't care who you are. I just showed y'all people that I was with just a couple months ago, whatever, even told me like, yo, E, of course, you know, we was coming to this. Now we ain't gonna be able to go. This is real, y'all. I can't pay for time. I don't care how deep you think you are, how sweet you think you are. God got your number. He know where he laying you to rest. You can't get no more time because you're fine. You might use your fine on me. You ain't about to use it on the creator. I don't care how smart you think you are. I don't care how handsome you think you are, how cavalier you think you are. I don't care who you are. God decides when you go to sleep and you don't wake your butt up no more. But you get to decide how you spend your time. And you get to decide when you're in a relationship to stop taking and stop looking for money and just say, bro, what you need? I'll take that off of your hands. Watch this, y'all. I was in San Diego, went to a restaurant, saw an older gentleman. He was like, yo, E.T.? I was like, yeah. E.T., what you doing in San Diego? I said, I just moved here, bro. He said, bro, this kid right here, Blake, he watch you, bro. His mom just got shot and killed yesterday. I said, for real? Like, you serious? He's like, yeah, bro. And not to put Blake's business on the street, but when me and Blake talk, he said, E, what complicates it is my brother killed my mother. God said, be responsible for him. That's my son. Be responsible for him. That's my son. He just had one of the most traumatic experiences you could ever have. Blake said, I'm coming. I said, all right. He said, I want to pay. I said, okay, I'm going to let you pay because you want to make an investment. But we're going to call and we're going to get you a discount. I called my crew, prayer line. Yo, Blake coming. We need him somewhere to tip. He's like, don't worry about it. I got a room for him here. God says there's a lot of people that won't, but they ain't really serious. Like, they want your attention. They want you to be in their face. They don't really want help. He needs help. I just need you to be responsible for him. Whatever money you need, I got you. Whatever you need, I need you to be responsible for him. He lost his mother. He lost his brother. I need you to be responsible. I got him, God. And when you get to the point where you're responsible and you do what you told without complaining and murmuring, without saying, God, why me? Why I got to do this? You better be grateful, God asking your butt to do something. Who you think you are? Who do you think you are? God asking me to do too much. I don't understand it. Nobody said you got to understand. He just said, have a cheerful heart. That's all he said. Have a cheerful spirit. He said, I got Blake, God. As long as I'm alive, I got Blake. Are you hearing what I'm saying? You ain't got no money because you weren't responsible for what God told you to do. That's why you broke. You told God no, dummy. You told God no. You told God, like Maul said, I'm uncomfortable. Okay, Maul did it anyway. Nobody said you had to be comfortable. You just got to be obedient. And when people look at me, why are you so blessed? I just keep saying yes. Yes. What you want me to do? Yes. I don't say that's out of my range. Ain't nothing out of his range. So if you're the creator, you asked me to do it, you must have known I could do it. You must have surveyed and said, Eric is the best doggone candidate for the job. If you tell me don't do something, don't go there and don't charge, then don't charge. Don't say, well, if I don't charge, how am I going to make money? Just be responsible. And there are those of you, when you do work, people got to come behind you. Nobody should have to come behind you when you do your job. When you do your job. And your problem is, you work, but after you work, you leave so much work to be done. When you finish working, there's still work to be done. And you wondering why you ain't getting to the next level. To Marquay's point, you have not managed what God has given you. And so I leave you. All I need is to be able to sit in first class, go to sleep, and know that the person in the cockpit got everything under control. The last thing I want him to do is say, we about to crash, and Mr. Thomas, if you can come up here and motivate me for a quick second. I'm gonna need some motivation, my brother. I'm not really sure if I want to land this joker. I get on the plane confident that my man in the cockpit don't need no help. That in case of an emergency, he gonna grab that joker and he gonna land that plane. Because I know he has control. It's time for you to get in the wheel and have some control. And if you can't have control, just be honest and say, I can't do it, train me. But don't take people's money when you work for them and they still have to work after they pay you.